Hi everyone, welcome back to Vintage. Last week I was talking about The Man Who Planted Trees by Jean Giono. That was my penultimate 2016 Classics Challenge title. There'll be one more next month. And I was really pleased to see so many comments actually on that book, but also a few people who'd read the book themselves and had also really, really enjoyed it. So that was really nice to see. I had a couple of copies to give away. Lucky people winning those are Angela Gray and Tom Fish. So congratulations, both of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal addresses and I'll get those books off to you as soon as I can. So this week I'm talking about the new novel from David Grossman, which is called A Horse Walks Into a Bar. Now, David Grossman is quite a well-known Israeli novelist who I've never read before. So this was my sort of my first experience of reading him. And I know that a lot of reviewers have been saying that this book is very different to his other works, certainly very different to his last couple of works. This is because he, unfortunately, is sort of quite well known for the fact that his son, who was an Israeli soldier in the Lebanon whilst they were sort of fighting against Hezbollah, was killed 2 days before a ceasefire. And his last book was a sort of a celebration of his life, and it was all about sort of parents dealing with grief. Grossman is a peace activist, and has worked very hard, especially since, you know, to sort of lobby for that and campaign for it on the sort of, you know, the left wing of politics. This book is completely different to all of that, and this is kind of why I wanted to read it, because it sounded, I don't know, I was sort of intrigued by the sort of the idea or the setup of it, because as you may be able to tell from the cover, this is, or indeed from the title, A Horse Walks Into a Bar, this is a stand-up comedian's set, effectively. What you're reading is his delivery, or you're watching the evening through somebody in the audience, really. And I can't think of a book I've ever read that's done that before, which was intriguing, to say the least. And it's brilliantly done. First of all, it's really funny. It has got some very funny jokes in it. It's got some pretty offensive jokes in it as well. I mean, this comedian, he's called Dovaleh G, and he comes out, and as you might expect, you know, he's a pretty sort of cocksure, macho, makes some pretty offensive jokes about women and their appearance and all that kind of stuff, and indeed to the whole audience about where they live. But this, so it feels sort of quite old-fashioned, I suppose, in a way, that kind of stand-up comedy. But then what you realise as you're reading is that he's one of those kind of quite edgy comedians who is, you know, he's making jokes about his audience. So whilst he's pretending to laugh at other people, he's laughing at them. He's trying to sort of point out their weaknesses. And that is because this is a stand-up performance like no other. He has invited this judge, who is a former school friend of his, a former sort of childhood friend of his, to come and watch him. And this judge has no idea why, because they've not been in contact for years. I mean, since their childhood, in fact. So he's a bit confused about why he's been invited to watch this show. And as we are reading and watching Dovaleh deliver his... that's quite hard to say. Dovaleh deliver. I thought he did pretty well there. When he's delivering his sort of set, it keeps kind of going off on tangents. And we see that what's really going on is that he is sort of... going through some kind of catharsis on stage, really. He's sort of almost like he's put himself in court, sort of on the stand in front of this judge. He's trying to sort of atone for something or to sort of confess something about his past life. And that makes for a very compelling read. So it sort of starts off very, very funny. Then it has this sort of great anger. And then you realise that you're sort of witnessing a man sort of falling apart on stage. And what we're very, very gradually understanding is something about his past. In fact, several things about his past. And again, something about grief and something about guilt and something about responsibility. There is another woman in the audience who it turns out there is some kind of connection to as well. And it's so subtly done, the sort of the release of the plot, if you see what I mean. There are many books which I think look back into the past where two friends realise the sort of the importance of a single moment and how it might have sent them off in completely different trajectories in life. But none of them have taken the form of a stand-up comedian set. And I think that's what's quite impressive. I think it's far, far harder to do than he makes it seem on the page. In the same way that being a stand-up comedian and standing up and delivering jokes night after night looks so easy when they do it well. But of course, if you've ever seen anybody die on stage, you can tell it must be incredibly, incredibly hard and a hugely technical exercise as well. So as a technical exercise, this book is incredibly impressive, but I found myself really sort of excited by the anger and the emotion that was in it as I was reading through. I was talking a couple of weeks ago about wrath, and there was a little moment where I was like, oh, this is a bit like reading Roth. It's got that kind of sort of anger about it. That doesn't really sort of sustain because it turns into a very different kind of book. But it was exciting for a moment there for me as somebody who's desperately trying to find my Roth substitute now that he's not going to be writing any more books. So there you go. I don't really want to say any more because obviously I don't want to give away the plot details. And I don't want to tell you any of the jokes because nobody likes to have jokes explained to them. But there you go. That is A Horse Walks Into a Bar by David Grossman. Again, as ever, I have a couple of copies to give away. If you're interested, make sure you're subscribed, leave a comment below, and I'll pick two winners. Not next week, but the week after. And the reason for that is because next week, I'm going to be doing a couple of videos with Jen Campbell, who many of you will know. There's going to be a video on her channel where we're going to be talking about American classics, and there'll be a video right here where she's going to be talking to me about poetry, because it's an area of weakness in my reading. So she's going to educate me. She's going to give me some nice poetry collections and anthologies to get me sort of back on track. And there will be a giveaway, which will involve you watching both videos. So there you go. It's very, very important that you make sure you come back next week and watch both of those. They'll be, I promise, very good. Can I offer that guarantee? I don't know. That's for you to decide, I guess. But anyway, that is all for this week, and I'll see you next week. Take care.